Hi everybody, this is Christina, the AmputeeOT. Recently, I got a tattoo for science on my residual limb. About a year ago, I decided that it would be a really cool idea if I got a tattoo on my residual limb. So I went to the Amputee Coalition of America Facebook page and I asked, has anybody else ever tattooed their residual limb? Now I'm not talking about tattoos that you had before you became an amputee, and I'm not talking about tattoos that people have gotten if they don't wear a prosthesis. I'm talking about tattooing your lower limb when you wear prosthesis every day. I wanted to know things like, how well does it heal? How do you get it to heal? Is this even a good idea? Is it going to hurt to walk on your prosthesis? Am I going to have to walk around with crutches or in a wheelchair for 2 weeks while my tattoo heals? Nobody really had a good answer for me. Most of the comments on the Amputee Coalition of America Facebook page were along the lines of, why on earth would you do that? It's gonna be covered up anyway, nobody's gonna see it, you're putting yourself at risk of infection. That's a bad idea. As you may have guessed, I kind of like tattoos. So yeah, I got my body tattooed for science. Here's my tattoo. Right now it's 6 days old, and it's in that sort of peely phase where the skin on the very surface peels off, which happens with all tattoos. I would say if you want to get your residual limb tattooed, you definitely should not do it if you are in any way immunocompromised or if you have diabetes or problems healing anything. If you have a little bit of an issue with hygiene and keeping your residual limb clean sometimes, you absolutely should not get a tattoo on your residual limb, because if you don't keep your residual limb clean, you can expose yourself to risk of infection. Because I have so many tattoos, I've developed a way of healing them that works for me that is evidence-based. There's a little bit of an issue in the tattoo industry with exactly how to heal a tattoo. There's a lot of folk tales about the best remedies for healing a tattoo, be that A&D ointment, or covering it with a bandage, or leaving it uncovered, or not scratching it, or using lotion, or not using Neosporin, and unfortunately there's not a whole lot of evidence in the tattoo industry about the best way to heal tattoos. But there is a whole lot of evidence in the medical industry about how to heal wounds such as burns or other surface wounds or road rash. I think the best medical analog to a tattoo is road rash. And the best way to heal road rash is through moist wound healing. Actually, to be honest, there's a whole lot of really strong evidence that moist wound healing is the best way to heal a wound. Moist wound healing is basically the idea of keeping the wound moist but not soaked in order for the skin to epithelialize. And the earlier it can epithelialize, the better your wound will heal. And a tattoo basically is that, it's a wound. I use this stuff called Landerm. You can also use Tegaderm or Opsite Flexifilm. They're all basically the same thing. This is an occlusive bandage that sticks to your skin and doesn't come off. But it also is vapor permeable, so it allows some vapor transference through the film. To heal my tattoo, I applied Landerm immediately after the tattoo was finished, after cleansing the tattoo with Hibiclens. In addition to using the Hibiclens and the Landerm on my tattoo, I also cleaned my liner and my residual limb with Hibiclens to retard any bacterial growth that might be possible, just to limit the chances of an infection even more. I was really curious as to whether or not my residual limb would be too sore after getting a tattoo on it to wear my prosthesis, and I'm happy to report that while it was definitely a little sore, it was not even sore enough to make me limp, if that tells you anything. It just basically kind of felt like a mild sunburn. And if you've gotten tattooed before, you know the tattoos go through this kind of itchy phase. My tattoo on my residual limb did not go through an itchy phase at all. And I actually got the bunny tattoo that I showed you on the same day. And the bunny tattoo did go through an itchy phase. Obviously, getting a tattoo is not without its risks. But when you're getting a tattoo on your residual limb where there may be scarring or nerve damage or issues with healing, and then you're putting that limb into a prosthesis all day, you can see why there is a little bit of an additional risk to getting a tattoo on your residual limb. However, I think if you really want to get one, there are ways that you can minimize that risk. Step one is to wash your liner and your residual limb with Hibiclens before you go in for your tattoo session. Step two is to get your super awesome rad tattoo. Step three is to wait about 20 minutes before you apply the occlusive bandage. Step four is to clean your residual limb, especially the new tattoo, with Hibiclens and then let it dry completely. Apply the occlusive bandage and then leave it on unless there is a lot of discharge underneath it. And if there is, just switch it out for a new piece. Step five is to clean your residual limb and your liner with Hibiclens every day for about a week. Oh, what step was I on? Step 11 is to enjoy your awesome tattoo that people are only allowed to see when you let them. All in all, it was definitely successful. I don't know if I would necessarily recommend that you get your residual limb tattooed, but if you do plan on getting your residual limb tattooed and you want to follow the healing protocol that I followed for myself, click down into the description and I will have the entire protocol laid out step by step so that you know what to do and when not to do. If you've gotten a tattoo on your residual limb, or if you're thinking about getting a tattoo on your residual limb, I definitely want to hear what you have to say in the comments below, so let me know. Okay, everybody, that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments section below. You can subscribe if you like. I put out new videos every Wednesday. You can follow me on Facebook. That's facebook.com/amputeeot. And happy tattooing. See you later. Bye!